Hey guys
and girls,
today we will have a look at Detour, the new vector phase shifting oscillator from Hora. And actually it's more than an oscillator, it's a whole voice and it's polyphonic. It sounds great, it looks great. So let's really start with a short overview. Detour will be included also in the free collection of modules, but it will be polyphonic. Only in the commercial VCO, VCF, VCA collection from Hora. Of course, links in the description. Vector phase shaping synthesis is as complicated as it sounds. It's considered an extension of phase distortion synthesis. And basically we have two sine waves that are kind of glued together, and we have control over the interaction between them with horizontal and vertical controls for each sine wave. So I have it here connected to the scope. We can also listen to this, of course. And for now we see a sine wave, but if I start changing the vertical parameter of the first wave, which is also called V1, we will see that only the half of the wave is affected, and that's actually one of the sine waves. Yeah. The same will be with the controls for the second wave. Also with the horizontal controls, which are called D1 and D2. And we can also grab the dots with the mouse and move them around. And if they meet, we can move both of them together. Very cool. Now, as I mentioned, this is a whole voice, so we have also a built-in envelope. We have also a built-in multi-mode filter. So let's really start looking at some examples. Okay, so here we have a sequence coming from Entropia from the Geodesics collection. It will sound like this. Very nice. And as I mentioned before, we also have a built-in multi-mode filter on Detour. We have here Lopez, and of course we can also grab the point here on the grid, up and down resonance, left and right frequency. So we have Lopez, we have bandpass, we have high pass. Very nice. Okay, now we can also modulate the V and the D parameters and also the filter. So here I have the Twin Quartet, which is also from Hora. It's an LFO with multiple phase outputs. So let's first modulate the V and D parameters of both oscillators through their dedicated CV inputs. Now the CV inputs have a range of negative positive 5 volts, so 10 volts all in all. So let's make the connections 1, 2, 3 and 4, and we have dedicated attenuators. If you look here, we have this shape which corresponds to the shape of the attenuators. You can see there's also a light going on. So let's add some modulation, and it's also seenable on the grid, so I can grab the modulation or the attenuators actually and move it around. Let's also move the points away from one another, and everything is seenable on the grid, which is amazing. We can do the same also for the other oscillator. Very nice. Let's add also some reverb just for fun. Oh yeah. Okay, now we can also modulate the filter. So let's take another LFO. We have here the cutoff CV input, and also here we have the same attenuator with the same shape. Also this we can move on the grid, and we see it also. the grid itself. We go really nicely also in audio rate. Oh yeah. Of course, also band pass. We can also take this an octave up or down. Oh yeah. Very nice. Now we have another set of inputs, of CV inputs here that are called X and Y, and they have a different range from the V and D inputs. So if the V and D inputs had a full range of 10 volts, the X and Y have a full range of 5 volts, and they don't have also dedicated attenuators. So if we do something like this, we just get the full range. Oh man, this is a nice sound. Very cool, let's have a look at another patch. Okay, so here I have a sequence coming from the sec 3 going through fate for some extra variation. It will sound like this. Again, we can add some reverb and delay just for fun. Oh yeah. Yes, very nice. Okay, now I want to show you the built-in envelope. So when connecting something to the, or a signal, not something, a signal to the gate input, the built-in envelope will start working. So we will use the gate output from the sequencer. If we disconnect it, it will stop working, of course. So now we have here the controls, we have an ADSR envelope, and we have also a slow release mode. Have a slower release time, but I will take the release and sustain all the way down for now, and maybe just a bit release. I will have something like this, let's say, nice and snappy. Now we can also use this envelope for internal modulation. So we have here a triangle, we have a different shape this time, and this also corresponds to the different attenuators, also for the filter. So let's start with the filter really. Let's say somewhere here, and now I can start adding the envelope modulation. And you can see this also on the grid, and also here we have the amount. Oh yeah. Very nice, we can also do this, of course. Let's just move them a bit. So we can add also envelope modulation for the V and D parameters for each oscillator. Also here. Oh yeah. Oh yes. Very nice, and we can use, I have here two more rows from the sequencer that we can use for other modulation, for example, the X1. So you see now it's moving even more. And let's say the Y2. So we have even more movement. Really nice. Now let's add some crunch to the sound. Oh yeah, let's add some crunch to the sound with Vakumba. also from Hora, really nice overdrive module. So let's make the connections. Oh yeah, let's change the, oh, the algorithm here. Oh man. Oh yes, oh yes. I also have here some drums hidden up. I have the gate sequencer from POM2, sequencing knock, and also the snare drum and hi-hat modules from Hora. And I have also Chronoblob here for the snare, and also the Briatus and Rampage for some extra crunch. Let's have a listen to this. Oh yeah. Oh baby. Oh yes, very nice, very nice. Okay, let's have a look at another patch. Okay, so as I mentioned before, the commercial version of Detour is also polyphonic. So here I have the note sequencer from JW set to have four voices. It's sequencing polyphonically Detour. Let's also have a look at the CPU meter. So this is where it is now. Again, there are four voices here running. So it's really nice. Let's also have a listen to this. Oh yeah. So as you can see, there is some movement here. I'm modulating with Octo, which is Oct from DivKid and is true in VCV, or built after Oct. Modulating the V1, V2, D1 and D2 parameters, but also the cutoff point of the filter. You can see all the movement here. And I also have white noise. If I take it out, it's clean, but if I add white noise to the X2, for example, it adds this grit, this edge to the sound. Really nice, lots of movement, lots and lots of motion. Okay, now polyphony doesn't have to mean only ambient chords, so let's have a look at another example. Okay, so here, for example, I'm merging four different trigger sequences from the trigger sequencer from Count Modula. You can see here it's being merged, and this is triggering Detour again polyphonically. Now it's also triggering the ADDR sequencer from Bog Audio, which is also polyphonic. So this is sequencing the pitch of Detour. It will sound like this. Oh yeah. I have some delay and reverb as sound effects also. And I also have sample and hold, modulating the X and Y parameters, and I have again the twin quartet modulating the V and D parameters just to add some more movement. You can see it here on the grid. Let's put this voice in context and add some bass drum and hi-hats. Oh yes. Now here I have another Detour. This one is receiving another sequence, not polyphonically, but another sequence from the trigger sequencer. I'm also modulating this again with the twin quartet. We very nice. And I'm also using the, for the cutoff, I'm using the twin quartet and the built-in envelope also. So there is movement here in the cutoff point. This is how it will sound like. Oh yeah, a nice bass sound. Very nice. By the way, you can turn off also the points on the grid if you don't want to see them. This will, of course, if we have a look at the CPU meter, help with CPU also. So if I turn this on, oh yeah, you can see the CPU usage will go up. If I turn this off, it will go down a bit, so you can save some CPU, not so much, but still. Okay, let's turn this off now, put this back on. Very nice. Okay, so here I have another detour. This one is receiving notes from another ADDR sequencer. Here I'm also modulating using the FM input to add some vibrato to the sound, and here you can choose between linear and exponential FM. So you have the choice. This is a sort of a solo line, I guess. Let's have a listen to this. Oh, you can hear the vibrato also. Of course, we can play with the different parameters here on the grid. If you have some sort of an XY MIDI controller, it could be so much fun using it with a detour. But there is also a module from JW called the XY pad that we can use to modulate the grid here. So we take the X outputs to the X inputs and the Y to the Y. And now I can start draw something. And you can see already the movement there on the grid. Now it will start oscillating and will modulate. Oh yeah. Very nice. Okay, let's have a look at one more example. Okay, so here I wanted to show you the formant or vocal quality of vector phase shaping synthesis. So I have here a sequence going. I'm also modulating the D parameters of both oscillators with the BPM LFO. So it's an LFO that is synced with the clock. I'm modulating the multiplication of it with another row of the sequencer. This is how it will sound like. Oh yeah. Of course, again, reverb and delay. Now listen to how vocally it sounds like. I have it going again through some overdrive. This one is Kim, also from Hora. Oh man. Again, I have some drums here. Again, the gate sequencer, knock, snare drum from Hora, Bakumba to add some beef to the sound. Oh yeah. Here I have another voice, another detour, which is a sort of an arpeggio. So I have the note sequencer generating chords, which is then going to ARP, from Hampton Harmonix, which is then turning these chords into arpeggios. So this is sequencing another detour. And I'm also modulating its parameters with the black Octasource from Erika Synths, which was also, by the way, ported to VCV by the developer of Hora. So thank you for this. So it's an arpeggiator full of motion. Let's have a listen. I'm also modulating the levels here, so it will come in a second. Really nice. Okay, and that was it. What a beautiful sounding module. I have to say, this synthesis technique, this vector phase shaping synthesis, is super interesting, sounds amazing. Like always, there will be a link in the description to the patches we've looked at today. Feel free to download them and take a closer look. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you enjoy what I do, consider becoming a patron. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.